This video will cover questions regarding the topic of relative range, the rectangle. This is the first question. There is a rectangle with the length L and the width W. The length of a rectangle increases by 2 feet per minute. That means dL dt equals 2 feet per minute. The width decreases by 3 feet per minute. That means dW dt equals minus 3 feet per minute because it decreases. When the length is 15 feet, so L equals 15 feet, the width is 8 feet, W equals 8 feet. In A, we are looking for dA dt. The area is the length times the width. Differentiate implicitly with respect to t, then d dt of A equals d dt of Lw. Then dA dt equals, using the product rule, which is f times g prime equals f prime g plus f g prime, then dL dt times W plus L times dW dt. Now plug in all the information. dL dt is 2 times W equals 8 plus L equals 15 times dW dt equals minus 3. 16 minus 45 equals minus 29 feet squared per minute. That means the area is decreasing at a rate of 29 feet squared per minute. In B, we are looking for dP dt. The perimeter is 2L plus 2W. Differentiate implicitly with respect to t, then d dt of p equals d dt of 2l plus d dt of 2w. dp dt equals 2 times dl dt plus 2 times dw dt. Now plug in all the information. 2 times dL dt is 2 plus 2 times dW dt is minus 3 equals 4 minus 6 is minus 2 feet per minute. That means the perimeter is decreasing at a rate of 2 feet per minute. In C, if the diameter is C, we are looking for dC dt. And using the Pythagorean theorem, C squared equals L squared plus W squared. Differentiate implicitly with respect to t. d dt of C squared equals d dt of L squared plus d dt of W squared. Using the chain rule, 2c times dc dt equals 2l times dl dt plus 2w times dw dt. Then divide by 2 on each side. 2 is cancelled. We have to find the value of c when l equals 15, w equals 8, c squared equals l squared plus W squared, 2 to 5 plus 64 equals 289, which is 17 squared. That means C equals 17. Now plug in all the information. C is 17 times DC DT equals 15. dl dt is 2, plus w is 8, dw dt is minus 3. Then 17 times dc dt equals 30 minus 24, 86. Then dc dt equals 6 over 17 feet per minute. That means the length of the diagonal of the rectangle is increasing at a rate of 6 over 17 feet per minute. This is the second and last question. In the diagram of the square, S is the length of the square. The area of the square is increasing at a rate of 4 cm squared per second. That means dA dt equals 4 cm squared per second. How fast is the side of the square changing? That means we are looking for ds dt. When the area is 5 cm squared, the area is the side squared, then differentiate implicitly with respect to t. d dt of A equals d dt of S squared. Using the chain rule, dA dt equals 2S times ds dt. When the area is 5 cm squared, then S squared equals 5, then S equals square root of 5 and minus square root of 5. This is not the answer because S is greater than 0. Now plug in all the information. dA dt is 4. 2 times S is square root of 5 times ds dt. Then 2 times 1, 2 times 2. Then 2 equals square root of 5 ds dt. Then divide by square root of 5 on each side. Cancelled. Ds dt equals 2 over square root of 5. Then ds dt equals 2 over square root of 5 times square root of 5 over square root of 5 equals 2 square root of 5 over 5. Centimeter second. That means the side of the square is increasing at a rate of 2 square root of 5 over 5 centimeters per second. I hope this video has been helpful. If you have any questions, write them in a comment. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more.